Yeah, hello everybody. Today is my last day. I will arrive in Los Angeles, having cycled from New York to Los Angeles 5000K across the country. And now it's time to show you my setup. I used the Scott Addict Gravel RC gravel bike. Super fast, comfortable. And I have the Shimano GRX curb set, 2x11. I go with the mechanical one. I have the DI2 for my road bike, but I love it, but I don't use it for traveling. Simply, if something breaks with a mechanical one, I can fix it on my own. And I use Shimano because that is a global standard and you find the easiest way to find spare parts around the world. Then I have the Ergon SR Allroad Core Team Saddle. Once you find the right saddle for long distance riding, you don't want to change. And I have the lightweight Pfadfinder wheels, actually fully carbon. A lot of people ask me why I'm doing that for traveling, but I used them now for 2 years and I had zero issues ever. And they are super fast and light. And Schwalbe G1R tires, also quite fast gravel tires. And I go tubeless, of course, zero flats across the US, so this is good. And then I have the Ortlieb bike packing gear. This is actually a new color. It's coming out soon. I got it a bit earlier. And here at the front I have the Wahoo Element Roam that I always use for tracking. And I have the Supernova BP54 lights and also a backlight. So this is a super fast, strong light. It comes with a big battery, but with that I can actually even go down a pass with 70 km/h at night. It's completely safe. And now I will show you what I have inside the bags. So here in the front I usually put in my camping gear. So this is where the tent goes inside, and some clothes. And in the middle I pack the tools and everything that is heavy, and my wallet and everything, and usually sleeping bag and clothes get into the bag. So I am using the MSR Huber tent. It's less than a kilo, and the tent poles I actually put in the back one because they are a little bit too long for the front. Then I have the C2 Summit Spark 2 sleeping bag, very light and warm, and also mattress from C2 Summit. And here's my cooking equipment. I have the Zotto Windmaster stove, which is actually really a game changer. It's the lightest stove I know, and it boils super fast. With, of course, a pot and titanium spoon and a foldable bowl, actually. So everything ultra lightweight. I also have a little Leatherman knife. And then let's get to my clothes. Well, I have one set of clothing here. It's all from Ryzen. And I actually, as this is a comfort ride, I do have a second pair of jersey and shorts and even socks. So poor luxury. And then I have for cycling also one under base layer, a wind jacket, a rain jacket, and that's it. For camping I have boxer shorts, trousers, and a short and a long base layer for the night. And then let's get to the spare parts. I actually do have a lock, very small, but it's just for the opportunity thief if I leave it outside the supermarket for a moment. And a pump, a multi-tool, two spare inner tubes. And in here is actually a derailleur hanger and a few screws. Never go without a derailleur hanger. A selfie stick, and that's an adapter for the US. I do also have a headlamp for the night. And in here we have more electronics like the GoPro and so on, and my wallet and passport. A few toiletries, a power bank, and my helmet and cables, and that's it. So Yeah, it's lightweight. I don't know the exact weight, but it's definitely in total maybe 17, 18 kilo and plus food. And yeah, I had zero issues with the equipment, zero flats or anything. 5000K, and now it's time to head down to the Pacific. Bye bye.